Hey, what's up everyone? Quick video today on a cool move that has seen a lot of requests for it to be covered, and that's going to be Pain Split. Pain Split is a unique move in Pokemon, mostly because it often acts as a form of recovery on Pokemon who otherwise lack good recovery. But before I can get into why that is, I need to first explain the actual mechanics of the move Pain Split. When used, you take your target's HP and the user's HP, and both Pokemon's health is changed to an average of the two. Another way to put it is if you take both HP stats of the two Pokemon, add them together, divide it by two, and now both Pokemon have that new HP stat. I should also mention though that if the new average exceeds a Pokemon's health, that caps off at a maximum. So for example, you can't Pain Split a Blissey with Shedinja and suddenly give it 300 HP. And that was a lot of numbers, so let's take a more practical example here. I've got a Gengar in the current underused tier who's just a great wall breaker, lots of special attack, a speed stat that's hard to contest, and an awesome move pool taking advantage of its unique Poison Ghost typing. However, let's say that I'm using this Gengar and I'm having a problem with it and its defense is being too weak. Its base 60 HP stat can be tricky to deal with, and I'm having a hard time keeping my guy healthy. To make matters worse, my opponent has an Assault Vest Amoongus, who just keeps coming in on my Gengar and stopping it from getting anything going. Its special defense and HP are very high, and with that regenerator ability, it's never going to be hurting for health when it comes to stopping Gengar. Now, this is a situation where Pain Split would come in very handy. All of those times your Gengar wants to come in on Amoongus can now be mitigated if you use the Pain Split ability. Amoongus's high health stat and Gengar's low health stat means that not only is your Gengar going to get a ton of health back, but you're going to do not insignificant damage to the Amoongus. In fact, you're doing almost as much damage to the Amoongus with the Pain Split as you would be with an attack. Not to mention, you gain health in the bargain too, of course. So in this specific scenario, it's even better than a recovery move, because you're also damaging your opponent significantly. Now, of course, that statement requires a massive grain of salt, because that's such a specific case, but you can definitely see the upsides in that example. Now, to be clear, the vast, vast majority of the time Pain Split is used by Pokemon, it's because they want a recovery move and don't have one available. For example, all the different variants of Rotom often act as pivots. They come in all the time with their useful typing, that useful levitate ability, things like that. Maybe threaten a burn with Will-O-Wisp, and then they volt switch out. Well, that entire role becomes a lot more difficult to do when all of your recovery on Rotoms is going to be just the 6% you get from leftovers every turn. Throwing Pain Split in that mix can help a great deal and give you an extra leg up on the recovery. It can also create situations like this, where instead of you just mashing recover and realistically getting nowhere in the long run, you're instead chipping your opponent down and almost creating a bit of a trade situation by the time they get the KO on you. Again, I think most of the time these Pokemon would vastly prefer a move like Softbolt or Roost, but it's certainly better than nothing, and it can help you continue to swap in on attacks and hazards over the course of a longer game. Definitely something to consider if you're building a balanced team, things like that. But with that said though, that's me done for today. Thank you everyone who suggested this video idea. A little bit of a simple, sweet one. That's what I like to see. I wouldn't have thought of it myself otherwise, that's for sure. But with that said, thanks again. Take it easy.